Welcome back to Ring of Fire. I'm Mike Papantonio. The Pentagon has finally found a way to cut down on their costs by illegally discharging soldiers with mental disorders that the military creates. I have veteran and attorney Howard Nations with me now to talk about this deplorable conduct. So Howard, it looks like the military has found a new way to scam military veterans, and that's to get rid of them with personality disorder diagnosis. Talk about that.
Well, Mike, in 2007, the House of Representatives Veteran Affairs Committee accused the Department of Defense of illegally discharging veterans with this personality disorder discharge in order to save $12.5 billion in health care costs and compensation that they would have had to pay to those veterans. That is absolutely ridiculous.
Howard, how does it work? Tell me how this latest military scam works. And it kind of comes a full circle, but I want to know what they're doing to get rid of military veterans now without any kind of benefits.
Well, a study was just released, Mike, where the conclusion is that the U.S. military, it has a systemic personality disorder discharge problem, and they're illegally violating discharge rules and have discharged 31,000 people since 01 as personality disorders. Now, personality disorder is an individual who has an inflexible, socially inappropriate behavior, which is, what is that? It's not a diagnosable major brain injury or any, it's an Axis II injury. Personality disorder cannot be caused by a major disorder. It can't be caused by substance abuse. It can't be caused by a medical disorder or a psychiatric disorder. And it's not incompatible with service. But in order to be a personality disorder, they have to find that it interferes with the duties of the soldier.
Okay, so Howard, let me ask you this. If I'm hearing you right, of course, you've handled cases like this in court when you've cross-examined psychiatrists on this issue. There's about eight specific kind of requirements to even make the diagnosis of PD, a personality disorder. And one of them is you have to go spend a lot of time with history talking to the family. That's not being done here, is it?
No, it's not. And also you have to have a very careful psychiatric examination. What we find is that the gravest results of this is that they're not reaching the real diagnosis. It's not that you're just putting people out because of a personality disorder, but people who do have these problems should be carefully diagnosed for the Axis I injuries. They should be carefully diagnosed for PTSD and traumatic brain injury. Now, you and I have both tried cases involving traumatic brain injury, and we know how difficult it is to prove and how difficult it is to diagnose. And we've also seen the consequences of people who are walking around with traumatic brain injuries and PTSD undiagnosed. There are 31,000 people
that
have had this.
Howard, let me ask you this. There's two parts to this as I see it. First of all, the money saved by the military getting rid of these people is huge. So they get them out there. They don't pay them any benefits because they say it's pre-existing. They could have served two tours in Afghanistan, one tour in Iraq, and they're gone. Part of the problem here that I'm seeing more attention to is the way that a lot of these soldiers were recruited. There was a time in the military where they simply couldn't recruit enough people. There was an unpopular war. People were being sent back from multiple stances in Afghanistan, in Iraq. And so they were going after virtually anybody they could recruit by giving some of these soldiers something called a moral waiver. And that is, they might have had criminal backgrounds, they might have had all kinds of problems. And so now they have them in the military. The numbers of military rapes have increased. You have extremism of every kind, white supremacist groups rising up in the military. You have some disorder, I guess is the best way to put it, with these recruits. Isn't this another way? Just now, you've used them up, you've sent them to Afghanistan, Iraq, now let's get rid of them.
Well, it's not just mere coincidence that this began in 2001. and has run since 2001. And the way they're getting rid of them is by the PD discharge, they deny disability benefits, they deny health care. They've even required some of them to refund their reenlistment bonuses. And then when they get out, they have the stigma of a PD discharge because it says personality disorder discharge. And this interferes with them trying to find civilian employment. So they denied disability, they're denied health care, and we have no idea what percentage of those 31,000 who have been discharged under the PD are in fact brain injured or have PTSD.
Howard, one thing we do know is after the media and congressional attention was paid to this and they saw that this looked like a scam, there was publicity, the numbers went from almost 4,000 of dismissals, discharges from PD to about 1,000. What do you think of that? I mean, isn't that one of the signs that what we're talking about is absolutely clear, this is a scam?
Well, it is. And what happened was in 08, Senator Obama and Senator Biden requested a GAO study. The GAO studied 371 cases, and they concluded that there were hundreds or even thousands of illegal DODs admitted the DOD even admitted that some of those people may have PTSD or TBI. What happened to the military response after the review, after the GAO review, the Navy, for example, did a review of the Navy in 08 and 09 and found that only 8.9% had been properly discharged. 91% failure rate after the review, after pressures brought by Congress.
This is a heck of a way for the military to save money. Howard Nations, thank you for joining me, okay?
My pleasure, Mike.